Yo, what is going on, guys? In this video, I'm going to be talking about my five favorite passing concepts that I believe you need to have in your scheme to be truly unstoppable in Madden 20. Now, whether you use abilities on your receivers or your quarterback to get said routes is completely up to you, or you could just be utilizing stock plays that have these specific routes. Now, I will do a video later on this week where I break down specific plays that have these built-in routes. But for the sake of this video, I'm just going to be utilizing a Hot Route Master quarterback, and I'm going to show you the concepts that you need to use out of multiple different formations to basically accomplish the same thing. It is going to be five total passing concepts that I believe are a must-have in your, you know, offensive scheme to be absolutely dominant. And with that being said, I'm going to go ahead and cut over to a video that was actually an interview that I watched this morning about Chad Johnson, Ocho Cinco, for those of you that know him by that name, talking about, you know, how the NFL is when it comes to schemes and overall offensive philosophy. So I'm going to cut over to that now and hope you guys enjoy the video.
Not over there.
When you say the system, you mean the X and O offensive scheme?
Nah, the offensive scheme. The offensive scheme doesn't change from team to team, only the language. Football is football.
You have these same types of offensive schemes that pretty much all utilize the same concepts. And that's pretty much what I'm getting to with this video, is no matter what your favorite formation is, no matter what your preferred style of play is, whether it is a pass-heavy scheme, whether it is, you know, a run-heavy scheme, but you need, you know, complementary passing plays, these are the types of passing plays that you will need to be able to create in order to, you know, truly have a dominant passing scheme when you choose to use it in Madden 20. So with that being said, let's get into the first one, which we'll get into right now. All right, guys, so here we're going to get into the first concept, and that's going to be to utilize dual post and dual hitches. This pretty much does require the Hot Route Master ability, or at least a route chem ability to truly use. But as you'll see, you can utilize this concept in any type of formation that you're in. Here's a spread look where you have the hitches and the two post routes will audible over to the tight slots halfback weak. Once again, you've got dual hitches with post. You can even mix it up depending on who's on the hitches and who's on the post routes. Basically, as you'll see, I'm just going to scroll through some other formations, right? So here's gun bunch. But the reason you utilize this concept is because you have hitch routes that basically don't get guarded by anything. Your opponent has to really, you know, use a lot of defensive adjustments to stop hitch routes in general. Plus, they're very good for quick reads. So not only do you have that, but then you have two post routes that simply can't be guarded. You have to manually guard both of them because the hitches pull down all the underneath zones. And ultimately, if you have two of them, you can't guard both. So you're kind of in one of those situations where you're damned if you do, you're damned if you don't, because if you blitz heavy, you got two hitches, really hard to do, and guard both, especially if they're spaced correctly. And then to top that off, you have two crossing routes, two post routes that can't be guarded by any sort of zone or man combination that forces you to, you know, have to use those as well. So ultimately, this is my favorite concept in Madden 20. Now, the second most dominating concept in Madden 20 is going to be a flat and a wheel route combination. Now, when I say flat, you can utilize an out route, a baby out route, to get the same result. So here is the one at a single at a gun tight slots halfback weak. You also can go to gun bunch, which is a very popular one. Basically, at a shotgun, you are limited to wheel routes that kind of have that sharp cut. Mesh out of split close pats is another good one. But there's definitely a big difference between the normal cut that goes up the field right around the numbers and your regular wheel route, which goes a lot farther to the sideline. Now, you can use this to attack and glitch out any sort of, you know, cloud flat, a soft squat, any sort of curl flat, like basically any sort of flat zone you're going to run into, you'll be able to utilize these to glitch them out. They will not guard this concept. You can also utilize this in single back, which I'll show you here in strong close, that you can basically use at any time you want. Now, when you're under center and you're utilizing the stock wheel route, you want the wheel route going to the wide side of the field. Basically, it's always going to go to the wide side. Now, the next one I'm going to talk about is one that needs no introduction. This is going to be the rollout corner. Rollout corners, whether you have a escape artist quarterback or not, are something that you need to have in your offense. Simply put, zones do not guard them. If you are not utilizing rollout corners, no matter what the formation is, you are utilizing your offense in an incorrect manner. Rollout corners, especially once you know how to cut block and all that type of stuff, being able to get up out of the pocket and glitch out these zones on the sideline are an absolute must in Madden 20. Now, the next one we're going to talk about is going to be the motion slant. Now, the motion slant is phenomenal for a couple different reasons. One, no zone or man coverage is going to be able to play it, which means our opponent is going to be forced to take their user and basically sit at the line of scrimmage trying to, you know, guard this motion slant. That's going to open up these deeper routes like the post behind it or deep in or something along those lines, right? So basically, a simple little quick route like this forces our opponent out of blitzing, or if they are going to blitz, they're going to have to, you know, basically pick and choose right away what they're going to guard. If they make one wrong click, one wrong move with their user, not only can we attack them deeper down the field, but they also are going to have a very hard time picking off this low-balled motion slant. Now let's go ahead and talk about the final concept I want to talk about, and that's going to be the deep post and the corner combination on the same side of the field. What this is going to do is it basically glitches out the deep zone. And I use the word glitch very loosely because the deep zone's always going to follow that post route, leaving the corner to be wide open. We all know how well linebackers play. Linebackers have no shot of getting out there and guarding that corner route. So you can utilize this same concept in multiple different formations. Basically, you just need a corner and you need a post route. So here you see we're doing it out of gun bunch. It'll work there. You can go to trips tight end, gun bunch tight end. Basically, you're just looking to abuse the sideline with this route combo. Trips tight end is one of my favorite because of the fact that it spaces everything out so perfectly. So this is a play and a concept I use a ton out of that formation. Now, let's go ahead and talk about and expand on this just a little bit, right? Because I want to talk about the ability to not only utilize this concept, but take complete advantage of it. And I think that if you use this concept with the deep post, the corner route, but also have a deep dig on the play, like you see right here, the ability to hit this backside dig, this 10, 15 yard dig route that you can run, will basically kill any sort of man or zone in Madden 20.